Hallyu refers to the global popularity of South Korea's cultural economy, exporting pop culture, entertainment, music, etc. It means the Korean wave, which has become a global phenomenon, spreading to people of all races and ages. Thousands of fans will wait days to get front row seats to see the music artists, which are known as idols, and spend hundreds of dollars on goods produced by their idols. But does anyone know the effect of South Korean music? To be more specific, the effect it has had on South Korea's conservative culture and social growth. The only type of music that was produced in South Korea and was largely known before the Hallyu wave was traditional and trot theme from the early 1950s. Traditional music consisted of South Korean instruments such as jing, kwanggwari, bok, and jangguk. While trot music almost had an opera house sound, but had instruments accompanied with vocals. The lyrics of these trot sounds mainly focused on South and North Korean leaders because of tense relations with North Korea at the time. After the Korean War, South Korea became unstable and one of the poorest countries at the time, leading a South Korean general named Park Chung-hee to become South Korea's dictator in 1961. Park Chung-hee was very adamant about enforcing cultural conservatism, so much so that he had South Korean police patrol the streets with school rulers performing snap inspections on South Korean citizens to ensure that men's hair wasn't too long and women's skirts weren't too short. In 1975, Park Chung-hee established the Korean Arts and Culture Ethics Council, giving the government the power to oversee the censorship of all broadcasts, performances, and audio recordings. His dictatorship ended in 1979, with his assassination making Chun Do-hwan, who was ruling as an unelected coup leader, December 1979 to September 1980, become the new dictator. Chun Do-hwan decided to close all of the commercial television stations and licensed only two state channels, the Korean Broadcasting System and Munhwa Broadcasting Corporation. At the time, the underground music scene had grown large with a band called AD4, which was formed by Shin Jung-hyun, who was known as South Korea's godfather of rock, and other artists such as the groups HD6 and Keybros, who are known for their hit song, Let's Go to the Beach. Due to the strict censorship, none of the music was able to grow and become mainstream, but it still became large with more and more artists breaking out. When South Korea was finally democratized in 1987, broadcasting stations continued to be very conservative, only broadcasting what the now conservative culture saw fit to appeal towards more viewers. Until Seo Taji and the Boys, a rock and hip-hop group consisting of Jung Hyun Chul, Young Hyun Suk, and Lee Juno, debuted in 1992 with Non Arayo, which set the lowest rating record from the jury as Non Arayo was first performed on a talent show. Even though the rating was the worst in South Korean history, the album reached a skyrocketing 1.6 million copies sold, and Seo Taji and the Boys gained much attention from the youth audience because they were the first artists able to break out of the underground scene with controversial lyrics and unique dance moves, unlike anything they have ever been exposed to. The lyrics specifically talked about love and teen angst, which led many broadcasting shows to deny their performance. Many conservative South Koreans who grew up with leaders such as Park Chung-hee and Chun Do-hwan accused the group of brainwashing the youth, and this resulted in many fans sending hate towards these people. The underground scene began to gain more attention as Jung Hyun Chul, who formed Seo Taji and the Boys, was a former rock artist with the group Shinhwa, which was huge underground. Jung Hyun Chul set new fashion trends and broke gender norms in South Korea by growing his hair out, wearing skirts, and so on, but not because it looked good. In an interview, he said he wanted to break the conservative barriers, thus leading many fans to follow in his footsteps. In 1994, Seo Taji and the Boys released Classroom Idea, which criticized the South Korean education system's immense pressure on students to succeed academically on exams, with the lyrics, " The song was criticized for backward masking satanic messages. By then, Seotaiji and the boys were known for their unique messages within their music, and then came the next release in 1995 of Come Back Home, leading many runaway teens to return home, and a regret of the times that directly criticized the Korean government, saying, Regret of Times was nearly banned by the Korean Performance Ethics Committee for having such lyrics, and fans were not pleased, causing many protests to break out, and the nation's censorship laws were soon abolished in 1996. The group later disbanded that year, which left the general public in utter panic, seeing fans chase the van that they left in after the announcement of their disbandment, and crying on the streets. Seotaiji and the boys were revolutionary for South Korea's entertainment industry and introduced South Korea to the underground scene and many other artists to debut similar music like Seotaiji and the boys. This was known as the start of the modern Korean pop music, spawning artists like H.O.T., Park Jin-young, S.E.S., Shinhwa, and many more. These artists weren't shy from their controversial lyrics, as H.O.T. came out in 1999 with the song Aya, which talk about the fire that killed many kindergarten students as a result of the negligent staff that locked their children in the classrooms. Today, Korean pop artists like BTS, TWICE, Hyuna, NCT 127, and so on can bring an estimated $5 billion, according to a report published in the Korea Creative Content Agency to South Korea in 2017. Global groups like BTS can make an estimated $57 million per year, making South Korean entertainment a multi-billion dollar industry, boosting the South Korean economy and South Korea's social growth. The underground scene has become more active, with many artists debuting as idols, but many continuing to make punk rock music and rap music, although being overshadowed by Korean pop groups. Some underground artists like Keith Ape sign with labels and become big overseas, making hits such as Ijima, which has introduced South Korea to a lot of American music. Many females also have a strong presence in the underground scene, creating a wide variety of music such as Sifika with her song My Ego, and one of the most notable, Lehigh, who was able to successfully break out of the underground scene and become a major Korean R&B artist, collaborating with many Korean pop idols such as V.I. of Icon in her song No One, which talks about being unable to find someone to call your safe place. This has also changed the perception of South Korea due to its global fan base, negatively and positively. The fan base helps spread the Korean culture, but it's also that fan base that can give people negative views, one being the makeup and femininity of male Korean pop idols. The stigma that since they are wearing makeup and have relatively slim bodies, it makes them gay or transgender, which is false. The makeup is required on stage, and the slim bodies are ideal in Korean culture. Same for many female Korean idols, who will starve themselves until they pass out. That doesn't mean there aren't any LGBTQ+ artists in the industry, although very few do exist. Some artists that are open with their sexuality is Holland, a gay solo artist. Hansol, who is openly asexual and former member of the group Top Dog. Choi Hanbit, a transgender singer and a model. And many others, while there are also many LGBT allies in the community. That doesn't mean there isn't a stigma around LGBTQ+ people in Korea, but is becoming accepted as years pass and as idols show their positive opinions on the topic. The South Korean culture does not consist of conservative norms, and the broadcasting stations still have regulations to follow, but otherwise, the South Korean conservatism established by Park Chung-hee and Chun Doo-hwan has been re-established, giving people new beliefs and allowing broadcasting stations to air performances containing more variety.